Hi there, Jim Becker with the RV Corral. Welcome to our website. Hey, I've got a brand new 2017 Keystone Cougar. This is a 24 SAB model, really nice floor plan, one of their best-selling floor plans. Actually, it's kind of a balance between something that's going to be big enough to be comfortable in, but not so big that it might be hard to get in and out of the spots you like to camp at. So you'll see once we get inside, it's got a really nice floor plan, open layout. Part of their half-ton series, so they're lightweight. You don't have to have a big truck to pull it around, even an SUV or some type of all-terrain vehicle will work to get this around safely. Notice on the front, does have a nice molded fiberglass cap, one-piece molded cap with lights inside of here. The nice thing about having a molded cap is you've got less seams, so it's all one piece, so you don't have to worry so much about things breaking down over a period of time and causing seams to want to leak on you. It does have an electric tongue jack on the front, really nice feature. It makes it more convenient when you're hooking up. Loading and unloading is just a push of a button. You can raise and lower the front of your trailer. All your propane tanks are up front here. You've got two propane tanks in here. We're going to make sure that you have full propane when you take this thing out of here. Easy access to the top so you can get to the tops of your propane tanks too, so you can shut those down if you need to. Also has a spot up here for your batteries. We're going to have two batteries, two brand new batteries that are going to come with it. If you take a look down the side here, you see that it does have a nice large patio awning. Really nice. You can open that up. It's electric, so you can just do it with the push of a button. It even has LED light strip underneath there, so that'll all light up. So at night, when your awning's out, you'll have your patio side. You can be out here enjoying the weather and have a nice ambiance with some lighting. Good storage, has a good pass-through storage compartment. It goes all the way across. Large size doors to get bigger things inside of here. This is a welded aluminum frame trailer, so it's built really well. This is not a entry-level trailer. This is a really good constructed quality trailer. I like to point out too that the welds, if you look down the side, you can see they're all full welds. The reason I mention that is because sometimes the manufacturers will just spot weld something. They'll just put a couple of beads on it, call it good. You know, this is done professionally, and you know, they build these with the intention that, you know, this is going to be here for the long duration. You know, that's one of the reasons why the Cougars have such a good reputation, because they are built well and they do have a higher resale value because of that. People recognize the quality and the fact that they are built to last. I like the fact that it does have a plug-in right here too for solar, so it's already wired for a solar system. So if you put in if you got yourself a portable solar panels, you could plug in here and it'll keep your batteries charged up. So if you're a dry camper, like to get off the beaten path, you don't have to be plugged in somewhere to keep your batteries charged up. Notice the nice finish on the outside, nice fiberglass finish. These are built in Pendleton, Oregon too, by the way. I mentioned something about construction, and we like the fact they're built in Oregon. Made for the Northwest. This is the Northwest edition, or the Western edition. So this is the ones that they build for our area. Fully enclosed underbelly, so that adds to the all-season use. You've got heated area back underneath there, so all that enclosed area has radiant heat. When you have your furnace on, they put foil wrap insulation barrier underneath your tanks too, so very well protected. In fact, they're 0 degree tested. They have Keystone has an outside company test these in 0 degree conditions, so they'll put them in conditions of at 0 degree temperature for up to 72 hours to make sure that they hold up and that they don't fail. So most of the time you're not going to be out in that kind of weather, but if you got caught in a storm, it's nice to know that everything isn't going to freeze up on you as long as you're doing the right things. The main thing being just keep that furnace on. Everything's going to have heat that way. Notice the nice steps. You've got two doors on this unit. This one's going into the bedroom area. The main entrance is on the other side, but they have nice heavy-duty steps. This one has a black tank flush also, so you can hook up a hose to that, put pressured water to it, keep your black tank from building up on the inside. It's going to spray inside of that tank, help keep things from building up on the inside of the tank. 110 outlet here. Notice the alloy wheels. Has a more ride suspension also. You can kind of take a look down here. You can see that this has an advanced suspension system. What that's going to do for you, it's got like a 3-inch throw. There's a rubber grommet that's in there. It works like a shock absorber. And it gives you a lot less road shock. That's kind of the bottom line. So if you're going over bumpy terrain, it's going to help keep things from bouncing around inside of your trailer. So that's a really nice feature to have. Adds to the towability too. Notice the frameless windows. Really nice look to those. I like the lend-a-hand. This is a nice feature too. Makes it easier to get in and out. As we move around to the back side of the trailer, notice it has the slide out bumper. I've got it out right now. Just a couple of pins here. You just pull these pins, slide it out, gives you a good space to throw maybe some firewood, could be ice chests, maybe a generator. If you're dry camp, you might want to have a generator. You notice your 110 or your 30 amp service power cord is right back here too, so you can plug right in to your generator and just slides in and out. Very easy to work. Ladder to the roof has a one piece roof that is it's crowned a little bit. As you can see, if you look up there, you can see it does have a little bit of a crown to it to help keep the water from building up on top. It is set up for a backup camera, so you could have a backup monitor system added to this if you wanted to. As we look over here on the utility side of the trailer, you can see you got a nice slide out, nice deep slide out with big windows in the side. We'll take a look here in just a minute as we go inside. Hot water tank over here, plus it has an outside shower as well. All four corners of the trailer have stabilizer jacks too, so you can help stabilize a little bit when you're out set up somewhere. Solar prep already ready to go. Let's take a look inside. You'll like the floor plan. I think this is really a good layout. I like this getting in here. Notice as we come in, you can see that right off, you can see that it does have a nice kitchen area, rear kitchen with stainless steel sinks, nice two deep sinks. Comes with a sink cover also, so you can use that for additional counter space. Typically with a rear kitchen, you're gonna have a little bit more, not only a little more counter space, but also some more cupboards, more storage back in the kitchen area. A nice slide out. Notice how they come out all the way, these doors do. Nice heavy-duty metal glides. Comes with a microwave. Three-burner stovetop with a 22-inch propane oven. So you got gas oven and stovetop. Microwave convection, or not convection, but a microwave oven. 8-cubic-foot refrigerator, two doors, so you got freezer separate from the refrigeration unit. Nice layout. Plenty of room for your stuff as you get out on the trail. Coming into the door, I want to point out too, I like the fact that they have a lot of your controls right here next to the door. So I mentioned that the awning is fully electric, so you just have the push button right here, moves it in and out. You've got controls for your lighting, water pump, hot water heater, all that you can turn on. You operate right here, slide out control right here. You can check all your tank levels too. Check the battery and your fresh water tank, gray tank, so on and so forth. Dinette booth makes into a bed, so this is another sleeper. There's nice pull down shades, so you've got privacy shades. There is storage underneath the dinette seats too on both sides, so you've got additional storage down there. Even has a little storage compartment over here. where you've got a nice shelf right next to the dinette with the TV that swivels out, so you can move this TV out, be able to watch it from your this out of the way. Over here on the opposite side, you've got your sleeper sofa. This sofa actually is a trifold sofa sleeper, so it makes into a bed. You got additional storage up here, and a nice pantry right here with adjustable shelves, so you can adjust these shelves. Another drawer down here. Now, the bathroom area, this is a side aisle unit, so you've got your bathroom all in one. So you don't have a split bath. So your toilet, your sink, your shower all in one area. Notice too, it does have two ways to get in. So it's a Jack and Jill arrangement. So you got door coming in from the bedroom area and also from your main living area. Nice stand-up shower with skylight that lets in some natural light. We don't have any lights on in here. You can see it really lights it up in this bathroom area. And then you do have additional storage in here also. You get into the bedroom area, you can see it has a nice wide king size bed. This is a what they call a RV king. Good storage down below here too. You can see there's that sink cover we were talking about. Storage in there. Storage up above the bed, and then you also have storage on both sides too. So you've got hanging storage space and a nice headboard with additional storage. There's also a light back up in there, and you can see on both sides of the bed there's 110 outlet, so you've got power on each side of the bed with shelves, so you've got a place where you can set something up. Especially, you know, there are some people that have sleep machines that help them sleep at night, so it's a great place to be able to plug in there. Really good layout. Again, one of the most popular floor plans they have. It's you know, it's considered, again, one of their half-ton towable series, so it's really easy to get around. I'd love to tell you a little bit more about it. If you would ask for me, I'd appreciate it. My name again is Jim Beckler, and my direct number is 541-510-1017. So give me a call, I'll be glad to help. Thanks.